No, good afternoon all. I think Gajre sir has started impression making. Okay. So I have taken steps in danger fabrications earlier. Okay. And afterwards we have started each and every step in detail. Okay. So Gajre sir has started impression making. Okay. So I will start jaw reduction. Okay, after impression making, you are going to pour the cast into your dental stone and prepare master cast or master cast. You are going to prepare wax occlusion rings. These wax occlusion rings we use for our jaw relation purpose. Okay, they act as an base or the external media, okay, to record our maxillomandibular relationship. Okay. So as far as your jaw relation is concerned, okay, see now each and every whatever each and every word of my presentation, whatever I am going to speak now, okay, is very much important for your entire life. Okay, now this jaw relation is not concerned with your complete danger patients only. Okay, this jaw relation is concerned with each and every patient which you are going to rehabilitate. Okay, if you are doing a full mouth rehabilitation with the help of fixed bridge or with the help of implant, or you are doing unilateral replacement, bilateral replacement, one arch, okay, that time you have to take a jaw relation. Okay, so this jaw relation is a basic step which is used for your entire dentistry. This is a very important step. Okay, so I know now you are in, just you have completed your pre-clinics, okay, so I'm not expecting too much from you people. Okay, only what is jaw relation and what you are going to perform in clinics as far as your third year is concerned, what is the basic idea, basic logic behind recording jaw relation, you should know. Okay, so basically this jaw relation is nothing but a maxillomandibular relationship. Okay, I'm again repeating one thing, that Gajre sir is taking impression steps, impression making. I am covering second step of denture fabrication, that is your jaw relation. Okay, so in jaw relation now, there are three types. Okay, which are those three types? First is your orientation relation. Okay, second is your vertical relation. Just listen, I'm not expecting too much from you people, only just listen and just understand the concept of this jaw relation. What is basically this jaw relation is? Okay, so orientation relation, vertical relation, and third is your horizontal relation. Okay, jaw relation is nothing but a maxillomandibular relationship. Okay, any relation of mandible to maxilla is your jaw relation. Basic types are orientation relation, second is your vertical relation, and third is your horizontal relation.
Horizontal.
Okay, again in vertical relation there are two types. Okay, vertical at occlusion and vertical at rest. Just remember these two terms, vertical at occlusion and vertical at rest. Okay, now coming towards third type, that is your horizontal relation. In horizontal relation also there are two types. Which are those? First is your centric relation, second is your eccentric relation. Okay, so as far as your jaw relation is concerned, okay, what is important for jaw relation? So what is basically this jaw relation is? Now just sit upright and relax. Okay. Just occlude your teeth in contact like this. Okay. Now try to glide your lower teeth on upper teeth. Move your mandible in forward. Like this. What happened? Your mandible moves in forward direction. Okay. Afterwards, just go back, closing your maximum intertuspation. Okay. Afterwards, take your mandible towards right side. This is your right lateral movement. Okay. Again, come towards normal incentive relation. Okay. Take your mandible towards left side. What is this? This is the left lateral movement. Basically, what is jaw relation and what you should know before coming towards the jaw relation? I have already explained. It is an any relation of your maxilla and mandible. Okay, it is clear. It has three types. Which are those? Orientation relation, vertical relation, horizontal relation. In vertical, again, vertical at rest, vertical at occlusion. In horizontal, centric and eccentric. Okay, it is clear. Okay, afterwards, I am coming towards the movements of mandible. Why this jaw relation? Why? What is jaw relation? Which factors affect this jaw relation? Okay, now when I move my mandible towards forward, that is this protrusive movement of my mandible, then my mandible can rotate, can move towards right lateral side also, then it can move towards left lateral also. Means what? I have already said that it is an any relation. Means which relation I have to consider for this? Should I start my rehabilitation of prosthesis with protrusive movement? Or should I start my prosthesis, fabrication of prosthesis with right lateral, left lateral? Which movement of this mandible maxilla? See, these mandibular movements is a big vast top. Okay, I am just related to your jaw relation. Which portion of your mandibular movements is important, I am just taking now. Afterwards, I am going to take a detailed lecture on these mandibular movements. How these mandibular movements occur? What is the role of these mandibular movements? How the condyles, each you already know, you have passed your anatomy. Okay, you know the anatomy of your temporomandibular joint. Okay, you know there is one, two condyles which are fixed into your glenoid fossa, and when you open or do any movement of your lower jaw, what happens basically? The condyles, the respective condyles moves or translate. It may depends upon the type of activity you perform into the glenoid fossa. Just like this, this is my condyle, this is my glenoid fossa. When I open, this translates like this. again on the basis of degree of opening. Earlier for 20 degrees it rotates your condyle, use the rotatory movement. Afterwards it translates into the gonad. So that is a big and vast topic, but why I am covering this here mandibular movements, because it's related to your jaw relation. And listen, until you know the basic portion or basic idea behind this all, you are not going to understand the jaw relation in detail. Okay, so one thing, jaw relation, types, mandibular movements. Okay, now as far as mandibular movements are concerned, you know that there can be protrusive, there can be right lateral, there can be left lateral or any other movements. Okay, now coming towards the our orientation relation. Okay, now in maxillomandibular relationship, who is stable, which jaw is stable? Your maxillary jaw is stable. Okay, so when I take or when I record anything, that time I record with respect to one thing. Means what? I record my this jaw relation with respect to my maxilla. Means what? Here your maxilla is a stable. Okay, now my mandible is moving. It is suspended in this air with the help of ligaments and tendons. It is like this. It is a bracing like this. This mandible is bracing like this. Okay, no any muscle is there. So only with it attached with the help of your tendons and muscles, ligaments. Okay, so this movement of your mandible to your maxilla. Maxilla is static. Okay, means what? Maxilla is static means what? I should know the basic inclination, basic position of your maxilla also. I am going to find the position of mandible. Okay, but I should know the basic position of your maxilla also. Though it is a stable. Okay, so as far as your orientation relation is concerned, what we do in orientation relation, we just check the inclination of your maxilla to your base of skull. It's clear? So as far as your orientation is concerned, what we do, we record the maxillary angulation, how it is your maxilla is oriented, how patient's maxilla is oriented with base of skull, and I have to transfer that record on articulator. Okay, so orientation relation is not only recording the position of your orientation of your maxilla. Okay, along with that you have to transfer it on your articulator. For transfer purpose we use Facebook device. Okay, I will come towards orientation relation in detail. Okay, but to make this topic simple, I have divided it into orientation, vertical and horizontal. But the jaw relation started with orientation. That's why I am doing some introductory portion of your orientation. So as far as orientation relation is concerned, you should know that we have to just record this maxilla and we have to transfer this position of maxilla with base of skull. Okay, that much is that much knowledge regarding orientation is good for this stage. Why? Because orientation relation is again a big topic. okay, I will cover it in 2 to 3 lectures. Okay. See, in third year, what I should know or what I should going to tell you is important. Why? If you read directly, like orientation, in orientation, the Facebook transfer, you will get confused. Okay, so what we do in clinics and as per UG purpose. Okay, I am starting this with vertical relation first. After I will cover horizontal relation, and in third part, okay, I will cover orientation relation. It is clear? But before starting with vertical relation, you should know regarding the orientation relation. That's why I told the basic thing regarding orientation relation. Now coming towards our jaw movements. Okay. Now just relax, sit upright. Okay. And just relax your shoulders. Okay. Now just swallow. Swallow. And relax. Swallow and relax. Swallow and relax. What happens? When you swallow, your lower teeth touches with upper teeth, that comes in occlusion. And when you relax, after swallowing, when you relax, what happens? Certain space will be created automatically between your upper teeth and lower teeth. Yes or no? And if you are not doing this way, just say Ram. Say Ram, 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 and just stop. What happens? Ram. What happens? Ram. Your mandible go away from your maxillary teeth or your lower teeth. And in your upper teeth, there is a certain gap. See, now I am going towards another concept. Okay, why jaw relation is difficult? See, I am covering all these basic concepts here. Okay, why jaw relation is difficult? Because these basic terms and basic concepts are not clear as far as students are concerned. That's why they call it as a difficult topic. Okay, now when I say Ram, what happens? My mandible drops down. This drops down means what? This drop down means nothing but mandible at rest. Mandible at rest. Okay. And just occlude it in. When you occlude, it is your mandible in occlusion, means vertical at occlusion. It is clear? See, when I say just close your upper and lower teeth, means your teeth are in maximum intercuspation, means what? This is nothing but your vertical at occlusion. Okay, when your mandible is in rest position, what is rest position? When all the elevating muscles of mandible and the depressing muscles of mandible are in tonic equilibrium, minimum tonic equilibrium. Okay, when you say Ram and your mandible goes into the rest position, what happens? Actually, all the elevating muscles and depressing muscles are in minimum tonic equilibrium, so that there is a space. And this space is nothing but your free will space. Okay, now just again sit upright, relax your shoulders, just say Ram or just swallow and drop your shoulder, drop your mandible in rest position. What happens? With the help of your tongue, you can feel there is a space all around in your lower teeth and your upper teeth. This space is nothing but your freeway space. Okay, when you close the mandible in maximum intercuspation, what happens? Your lower jaw touches to your upper jaw with the help of your teeth. Okay, that is your vertical at occlusion. Okay, and when your mandible is in rest position, okay, that means your that is your vertical at rest position. So from your jaw relation, I have just started with mandibular movements. Okay, again some part of your orientation relation. Okay, and again I have directly taken the vertical relation as first relation to record. Okay, so before how to record this vertical, now you know that what is vertical. There is something means what? There is a space means what? I have to create that space in patient's mouth. Okay, I should know where my maxillary teeth should end, where my mandibular teeth should end in that patient's mouth. Why? Why? Because I have to create same space. Which space now you have filled? That space also I have to create in patient's mouth. Okay, that's why I should know basic things to create such to record such this freeway space. Okay, so as far as your preclinics is concerned, what you have done, you have prepared your wax occlusion rims. Okay, anteriorly, what is your height of your wax occlusion rims for maxilla? Near about 22. For posteriorly, near about 18. Okay, for lower wax occlusion rims, near about 18. Overall, yes or no? Yes. So why it's important? See, just on your own, you are feeling that when you swallow and relax your mandible, there is a formation of space. Okay, means what? Means what? Your wax occlusion rim is there. Now just imagine that your wax occlusion rim represents your the tip. In jaw relation also, these wax occlusion rims are nothing but they play a role of your missing teeth. Just consider these are our teeth. Okay, when this wax occlusion rim I insert in patient's mouth, okay, so where should I stop? What height should I maintain for that patient? Ideally, I have fabricated wax occlusion rim which has height of 22 millimeter anteriorly, 18 mm posteriorly. But when I am going to perform work on patient, now here for each patient, each jaw size is different. So there are some factors. There are some factors on the basis of which we determine how should be the or what should be the length of height of our wax occlusion. Okay, so which are those points or which are those factors? Just insert wax occlusion rim in patient's mouth. Okay, now your patient is sitting like this with his back rest, with his head rest, shoulders are relaxed, seeing in front. Okay, and from frontal view, when you see that your upper wax occlusion rim is visible, 2 millimeters slightly visible, when your upper resting lip, upper lip is in rest position, it is not in tense position, so the visibility of your maxillary wax occlusion ring should be 2 mm anteriorly. It can be now 22 mm or it can be less than even 22 mm. But the identifying factor is just anteriorly it should be visible. And as far as posteriorly, to check the limit of posteriorly, okay, you have to mark lines, certain lines on the face of patient. Which is that line? That line is your Kempner's line or Kempner's plane that starts from your lower border of your allograft nose to your upper border of your tragus. Just mark allotragus line on patient's face with the help of Fox plane. Fox plane is a device, okay, which has inner rims and outer rims. The inner rims goes in patient's mouth, okay, and outer rims just represents the position of your inner rim. Okay, so when I insert Fox plane in patient's mouth, the posterior rim of your Fox plane should be parallel to that Kempner's line. As far as height is concerned, adjustment of wax occlusion rings I have covered here for maxillary wax occlusion ring. Okay, now coming towards mandibular wax occlusion, just imagine where your teeth are, up to what level your teeth are. Just see in mirror. Up to what level? Which are those landmarks which can you can say that yes, my level of my plane of this occlusion is here. So as far as your lowers are concerned, it should be in a plane with your corner of your mouth. Corner of your mouth. So that I will adjust my lower wax occlusion ring to the level of my corner of mouth. Okay, now it's clear that I have fabricated wax occlusion rims. I have adjusted the occlusal plane. Okay, height of maxillary wax occlusion rim, height of mandibular wax occlusion rim. Okay, and now I am coming towards the vertical relation. So, what is vertical relation basically? It is a full length of face. Okay, what is basically vertical relation? It is a full length of face. The length of face as determined by the amount of separation of the jaws. Okay. The length of face. Actually, what is vertical jaw relation? Vertical, vertical. What is vertical? It is the full length of face. Pass. When your jaw is in rest position, what they have written here by the amount of separation of jaw. What is this amount of separation of jaw? That space you have filled before. That space, nothing but that amount of separation of jaw. Okay. When your jaw was at rest, that is your rest position, that is your vertical dimension at rest. Length of face, then see this now how they have written length of face when mandible is in rest position. That you have filled. After swelling, your mandible come to your rest position. That is your rest position of vertical. Okay, and then length of face, what they have written about here? Vertical dimension occlusion. Length of face when the teeth are in contact and mandible is centric. This centric now is your maximum intercuspation. When you bite like this, that bite is centric bite. Bite is centric bite. So, from this definition, you know that, or you should know that when you occlude your teeth, the length of face will be decreased automatically. It is yes or no? Yes. Why? Because the freeway space is escaped. when I occlude like this. See, my face is divided into three parts. This is first part, okay. This is second part, and this is third part. Okay. So when I occlude, when I occlude, so my length of face is decreased. Okay. When my mandible is in rest position, length of face, the lower half of my jaw is slightly increased. That indirectly the length of face is increased. Okay. So what they have written here, the vertical dimension at rest is equal to your vertical dimension at occlusion plus your that freeway space. That freeway space for many patients, it can be up to 8 to 10 mm. Okay, up to 8 to 10 mm. But generally we consider it as a 2 to 4 mm. Okay, as far as your complete denture process is rehabilitated, that time we have to create a freeway space of 2 to 4 mm. It can be variable, or it is a variable thing. It is not possible to maintain or to create 2 to 4 mm freeway space for each patient. No, your freeway space is different than another freeway space. When I rehabilitate your dentition, I will consider freeway space for you. Okay, but in general, the freeway space in terms of the quantity of it should be 2 to 4 millimeter. Okay, so coming towards our methods of recording this vertical jaw relation. Now you know what is vertical, okay, what is jaw relation basically, what is vertical at rest, what is vertical at occlusion, okay, and what is freeway space. Okay, now coming towards recording, how I will record this vertical at rest and vertical at occlusion, how should I record? So methods of recording vertical at rest, one method I have just explained you, which was that just relax, swallow and relax, swallow and relax. Okay, means what? I have to mark certain points on my face. I have to measure my vertical. Vertical is nothing but is a length. It is the length of your lower face. Okay. So I will mark at the prominent part of my nose, tip of nose, and the prominent part of my cheek. Okay. So that I will measure the length. Okay. Now I think only 2 minutes are remaining. Okay. So I stop here. But see, now it's a fourth year topic, but you have to follow this procedure in your clinics. And this is not only for prosthodontics, for your entire dentistry. What are you going to do in endo, prostho, pedo, in whichever branch or stream it can be, your jaw relation is not going to change. Okay, so just read. You are going to read in any book, whichever book you have. Okay, if you don't have book, just go on net, just search regarding, just type jaw relation PDF. Okay, just check for articles, or go, and if you have any book, it can voucher, it can nulla, whatever you want to read, but it is important to just check. Okay, just check what is this jaw relation is. Okay, and in next lecture, now I will take the cover methods of recording vertical dimension at rest. There are certain vertical methods to record vertical at rest, afterwards vertical at occlusion. Okay, and afterwards we will start with your horizontal relation. Okay, and afterwards orientation relation. So I think number 8 to 9 lectures I'm going to take on jaw relation. Each and every lecture is important. Okay, and side by side, Gajri sir will take impression making. Okay.